Hello friends, today we'll see how to write the part program for a slot milling. I've shown one component and this slot you have to make with the help of end mill cutter. But before watching this video, I would like to suggest you to please watch my video on how to write the part program. Okay, first I will read the program which is given. Or the statement which is given here, write a part program to machine the 10 mm slot inside the workpiece as shown in the figure. It means that in the exam, this diagram is given to you. Okay. Then use a 10 mm diameter end mill. Means you have to make this slot by using a end mill cutter. As shown in this diagram, this is the 3D sketch of the component. And this is end mill cutter. Okay. The part depth is 10 mm. Means total depth, okay, or thickness of this plate is 10 mm. And the slot depth is 5 mm. Means only 5 mm depth slot I have to make in this plate. That is the meaning of that. One more condition is given here. Use a depth of cut of 2.5 mm. It means that in a one stroke, I will not take a depth of 5 mm. Only 2.5 mm depth I will take, and then again I will take 2.5. In that way, I will take a total 5 mm. Next, assume the Z datum is at the lower left corner of a plate. Means here, this is the datum surface of this component. Okay. Now, how to write the program? For that, first of all, you should find the coordinates. Okay. Here also I show the diagram. I given the number 1 and 2. So what will be the coordinates here? You can see as per this diagram. The length of this component is 80, right? And the center to center distance, which you are observing in this diagram, okay, it is 60. Means remaining is 10, 10. You can see here 80 minus 60 will be 20. It means that 10 on the left side and 10 on the right side. So this position, this will be a x-axis, and here this will be a y-axis. Now first coordinate when I'm finding, how much is the distance from this position, this surface to the center point? It will be a 10. Okay. So that's why x I written 10. Then the Y position, this one. You can see in this diagram, this slot is at the center. How much is the width given there? You can see the width is 40. So half of that will be 20. Means our center which comes at the 20. That's why my Y will be 20. Second coordinates I have to find out. Okay, this one. See along the X-axis, you can see 10 plus 60 will be a 70. So my x coordinate will be 70 and y coordinates will be a 20. Same again, as the slot is exactly at the middle there. So I think this is the most important point, first of all, where we are finding the coordinates. After finding the coordinates, we are, any programs is actually divided into three parameters, I can say. First parameter, which is called as a startup program, means from N10 to N60, we are giving the inputs to the machines. And then again, the middle part, which comes, which indicates the profile of that component. And the last part, which comes in the program, will be the end of program. So like that, it is divided into three parameters, I can say. First, now, when you're writing the program, we are always giving the O program numbers. Okay. So you can give any program numbers which having 4 digits. Okay. I had given the 4 digits. Means you can start from 1 to 9999. Okay. 4 times 9. So I given just O1122. Okay. You can give any number. Then block number N10, G40, G80. When you're talking about the G40, it means that if the previous operators had changed the cutter or a tool, so you can cancel that command. In the same way, GAT is the can cycle cancel command. Next is the N20. G28, U0, V0, W0. It means that the tool will move to its home position, or I can say that automatically return to its reference positions. Then the N30 block, G90, G94, G21. When I'm talking about the G90, it means that we are talking about the obsolete positioning system. Then G94 will always indicate you the feed rate in mm per minute. And G21 will indicates you we are writing the program in metric system. Now all these dimensions which is given in this diagram, all is in the mm. So I have taken the G21 which we are writing in the metric system. Then block number 40, M06. You know that M06 will indicates the tool change. Okay. So here I have given the tool number 1. Okay, T01 indicates the tool number 1. T stands for tool. 01 is the tool number. And again, the 01, it indicates that the tool offset value for that tool number 1. Then the block number N50, M03. M03, it indicates that the spindle will start in the clockwise direction. At what speed? S stands for speed at the 1200 RPM, which having a feed rate of 100. You know that G94 mm per minute. It means that this feed rate is given in mm per minute. Then N60, M08. Now I have started the coolant. Okay. So this is just a beginning of the program. That is a startup program. So we are giving all the inputs to the machine. After that, now it's very important that the second part which will be generating is called as a profile of the component. Now I given the N70 G00Z5. It means that I'm rapidly the tool will move. So or the cutter will move. This is an end mill cutter. Lekin kahan hai usko 5 mm above the surface. This tool will or the cutter will just come on that component, but above the surface of a 5 mm. So Z will be always a vertical. Okay. So the maine yaha pehle usko cutter ko leke aaya. But at what position I am G00 extend Y20. It means that the tool will move to the position of extend Y20. Means exactly at the point number 1. This one. Okay. So I given here 1 and here it is 2. Right now. So the tool has moved to the position of X10 and Y20. Now, after that, you can see I written the block number 90, G01, okay, Z minus 2.5, feed rate I again 50 here. Now, G01, again, the cutter will move linearly, okay, and it will take a required depth. So, what required depth we have to take? Z 2.5, because it is a condition, it is given. Use the depth of cut 2.5. We know that the final depth is 5 mm. But as it is a given, the depth of cut you have to take the 2.5. So initially I have taken the depth of 2.5. So Z minus 2.5. Why it is minus 2.5? Because from this datum surface, the tool is moving towards the negative directions. So, यहाँ तक हमारा positive होता है, यहाँ से जैसे आप नीचे जाएंगे cutter को लेके, तो वो minus value होती है. So, that's why Z is minus 2.5. Okay. After that, the tool has to be moved. You can see here where the cutter has to be moved. I have to move the cutter X70, Y20. Means from this position to this position. Right now? So, for that reason, the next my coordinate, that is a point number 2, means this is my point number 2, whose coordinate is X70 and Y20. So the cutter will move from one position to the second position. So depth of cut has taken there, or material of 2.5 mm is get removed. And after that, I have to achieve the size of 5 mm. So what we'll do, again you can see, I've taken the block number 110, z minus 5. Means I have taken the complete depth now. Why it is minus 5 again? You know that from the datum surface, when the tool is moving below that, then at that time you have to consider the minus. So minus 5 I have taken. अब यहां से टूल कहां जाना चाहिए? इधर जाना चाहिए, मीन्स पोजिशन वन, मीन्स टू से अभी और वन के पास जाना चाहिए. सो आई विल पुट द अगेन द कोऑर्डिनेट्स, यू कैन सी हियर. सो व्हाट कोऑर्डिनेट्स आई गिवन? x10, y20. तो यहां से हमारा कटर पॉइंट नंबर वन पे मूव हो गया. एंड आफ्टर दैट व्हेन दिस ऑपरेशन गेट ओवर, मीन्स व्हेन यू अचीव दिस डेप्थ, ओके, दैट स्लॉट व्हिच वी हैव अचीव्ड, आफ्टर दैट I have taken the G00Z5. इसका मतलब अभी टूल आप यहां से ऊपर लेके आओ, ऑन द सेफर साइड. नाउ द लास्ट पार्ट दैट वी कॉल एज अ एंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम, हियर ब्लॉक नंबर N140, G28, U0, V0, W0. इट मीन्स दैट टूल विल रिटर्न टू इट्स होम पोजिशन. देन द N150, M05. यू नो दैट हियर वी हैव स्टार्ट द स्पिंडल. Okay, so here we are just stop the spindle. Then M09, here M08 indicates the coolant on. Here we are stop the coolant. And the last block is the N160, that is M30. M30 indicates the program end and tape rewind. It means that the cursor will move to the block number N10. It means that your machine is ready to generate other job or operations on the other job. Okay, so that's why we are using the M30 here, which is called as a program end and a tape rewind. So thank you, friends.